My name is Lloyd Geit. I never really thought about going to Cuba. It was not on my bucket list. It was not at the top of any list. But when Cuba was in the news with the U.S. warming and its relationships with Cuba, I thought, hey, this could be pretty cool. I've always known of Cuba, but not a whole lot. And I thought this would be a good trip. And I wanted to go to Cuba before it became so westernized. I wanted to see Cuba as Cuba was all of those years ago that we hear about. Now, once the U.S. gets in there, things are gonna change. I wanted to see it in its purest state. I wanted to see the people. I wanted to experience the food. I wanted to see the art. So this trip came up. A buddy of mine who's been planning all of my trips back and forth to Africa over the past 30 years said, okay, hey, we're bringing a group of people to Cuba. And I thought, that's cool. I want to go to Cuba. I want to see what Cuba is like. That is why I went to Cuba. And it is the best thing that's ever happened to me, with the exception of my travels to Africa. Cuba is, as the kids would say, the bomb. The major reason I went to Cuba was to see the art. And when I got to Cuba, I saw lots of art. It is amazing. The Cuban people are just clearly, clearly ahead of a whole lot of other people when it comes to art. There's art everywhere. There's art on the streets, there's art in the museums, there's art at the markets, you name it, there's art. But what I found really interesting is what they have at the museums. Now, the museums are just full of art. I mean, incredible art that we here in America don't see because of the embargo. So you see all of this wonderful art in the museums and all of these incredible artists is like, oh my God. And black Cubans who are doing these incredible pieces of art, black Cubans who are in the museums. It is amazing. But then black folks are everywhere. And see, that's another misnomer, that ain't no black folk in Cuba. If you and I went to Cuba today and walked the streets of Cuba, people would think we were Cubans until we opened our mouths. The color scheme goes from this end to this end, from the whitest of the white to the blackest of the black. They're in Cuba and in between. So we're all over the place. But to learn about Cubans, black Cubans who did art was just amazing. I mean, wings in the museums with nothing but art by black Cubans. Celebrated black Cubans, unlike we celebrate black artists here in this country. So there's art everywhere. We actually went to some artists' houses. We actually got to see some of them work on the art in their houses. Now that was quite interesting. You go to a building that was built in the 1700s, and this guy is creating art in this building that's still standing from the 1700s. Just really special. Just like the art here in America and in other places around the world, Cuban art is very similar in terms of they do acrylics, they do oils, they do pen and ink, they do pencil, watercolors, just, it's all over the place. They do just incredible art. Small pieces, large pieces, medium-sized pieces, really big pieces. But the thing that I found about Cuban art is that it's colorful. It's happy. It reminds me of the art by African Americans. African American artists are not afraid to use color. Cuban and Afro-Cuban artists are not afraid to use color. As a matter of fact, that's really what attracted me to the art. It's very vibrant. The colors just kind of pop out at you. And they paint all kinds of things. They paint people. They paint buildings. They paint cars. They paint, you name it, they paint it. There's also a style that is very similar to Picasso. Well, now, you know, Picasso stole his style from Africa. And there are that same style you see in Cuba. So the suggestion is that that's a very African style as well that Picasso made popular. Well, there are some artists there who do works that are so similar to Picasso, and those I really fell in love with. Those are absolutely, that little cubism kind of thing, absolutely wonderful. There's one Afro-Cuban artist in particular that I fell in love with. He goes by the name of Choco. and he's this tall, very dark Cuban. And as a child, he was so dark that they called him Chocolate. So he shortened the name to Choco. This man, his art is incredible. A bit expensive, but incredible. We went to Choco's house, and his house and his gallery are the same. And he had all of this wonderful art, just spectacular art. He's considered to be one of the world's top printmakers. He does a lot of prints, limited edition, and he is just at the top of his game. But the good thing was to go to the museums and see Choco's work in the museums. Of course, I kept a piece of Choco's work for my private collection. And this man is just something else. He was only, he was on his game. He was on top of his game. And the sweetest guy, this tall, imposing man, but just the nicest person you would ever want to see. And he just talked to us in Spanish. Of course, we had a translator there. And he just made us feel so comfortable. We have several of his pieces in the show. And he, to me, was such a delight. And then there are other Africans, Afro-Cuban artists that I fell in love with. They just have some incredible, incredible works. This is a huge transition for the Guide Gallery. All of these years, we've specialized in nothing but art from Africa. Strictly art from Africa. Original paintings by African artists who are still on the continent. But when you think about it, there's a segue, there's a section of where Africans are. Africans are in Cuba. Africans were brought to Cuba to work, just like Africans were brought to the US to work. The imprint that was left behind by the Africans to this very day, both here in the US and in Cuba, can be seen in everything. The culture, the arts, the foods, the dress, everything. That footprint is there. So I thought, well, why not go to Cuba and see what black people have done there and see if we can transition that to here. So this is an experiment for us. This will be the first time that we've ever offered for sale and for show art that is not directly from Africa. Art from Cuba. And if this goes well, and since Cuba is big in the news these days, everybody wants to get to Cuba and everybody wants to experience Cuba, well, this is another way for the gallery to make a statement, to say that we not only support African artists in Africa, we support African artists or Afro-Cuban artists or Cuban artists, however you want to put it, in Cuba. Believe it or not, I spent much of my time in Cuba shopping for art, which means that I was going from this gallery to this gallery to this market to that market to this market and that market. I had a thing. I was on a mission. I went to find art, and boy, did I find art. I brought back 60 pieces of art on paper, paintings on paper and paintings on canvas. 60 pieces of art to show to the people in Houston, all the way from Cuba. And I think it's safe to say that we're probably one of the first galleries, certainly the first black gallery in the city of Houston to showcase Cuban, Afro-Cuban art. Now, coming the 1st of March, for the whole month of March, we will be launching our Afro-Cuban and Cuban art exhibit. So now, what you need to do is to stay tuned to social media, because we will be giving you the dates and the times. This is a show that you do not want to miss. The Afro-Cuban and Cuban art exhibit at the Guide Gallery.